The story of Everton Football Club's ninth league championship is a story of triumph over the odds. A season which opened without seven senior men, all of them seriously injured, ended in title triumph because of the efforts of 23 different players and a manager who gave us the perfect going away present. It all began in the famous stadium where the previous campaign had ended so disappointingly 3 months earlier.
Can only sit on the Wembley turf and reflect that really he had no chance, as Everton, having been cruelly struck down with injuries and with such a weakened side, get the lead through Adrian Heath.
With just 10 minutes remaining, Everton's third consecutive Charity Shield seemed secure, but Ian Rush was again to have the final word, and the trophy was shared. Nevertheless, Howard Kendall's depleted side had signalled their intentions to the title holders and favourites Liverpool. And when the manager paid a record £900,000 for Norwich and England centre-half Dave Watson, they were set up for a winning start to their title bid. Nottingham Forest themselves, amongst the early leaders, were the first to feel the force of Kevin Sheedy's explosive finishing. 27 minutes into the new season, their goalkeeper Steve Sutton found it altogether too hot to handle. But Forest had their moments. Twice they hit the woodwork. Midway through the second half, Sheedy finished them off. Harper, Sharp, it's nice control, into the path of Langley, useful cross, too good for Fleming, Sheedy, too good for Forrest, another precise finish from Kevin Sheedy, Langley's teasing cross took the fullback Fleming out of the game, and although Des Walker came sliding in, Sheedy had already set himself for a cross shot which virtually clipped the inside of the far post. Twice behind against Sheffield Wednesday, behind again at Coventry, the Young Blues salvaged draws from their first two away games. Oxford United were next at Goodison, the team who had robbed Everton of the title initiative in the final week of the previous season. Their goalkeeper, Alan Judge, was sentenced to face penalty executioner Trevor Stephen after being found guilty of toppling Adrian Heath there. After 51 minutes of goalless frustration, Stephen dispatched the first of the 14 league goals that would make him the champion's top scorer. But the game was far from over, and Oxford equalised. Headed away by Charles back in defence. Here's Houghton, the Oxford goal scorer, but very cleanly stolen from him by Harper. Now Stephen. Harper again. Oh, he caught hold of that one. He doesn't score very often, but they do tend to be important goals if you're prepared to wait for them. A most popular goal scorer, Alan Harper. And yes, with his left foot. Stephen finding Adams. Cross looking for Sharp. And Briggs happy to help it on its way for an Everton corner. Just 8 minutes remaining now. And after, well, a forgettable first half display, Everton inside of a deserved victory. Watson forward for the corner. It's on the right-hand edge of the screen there. That's Kevin Langley beyond him. Swung in by Stephen. Ooh, Briggs was all over Sharp there. Here's Langley! And that will seal the points. May just have taken a slight deflection, but I fancy Everton might have had a good case for a penalty anyway. Briggs' challenge on Sharp, punished though in no uncertain terms by Kevin Langley. A goalless draw with Queen's Park Rangers was followed by a gutsy win over the surprise leaders Wimbledon, which gave Everton the chance to move into second place if they could mark their first television appearance of the season with a win over Manchester United. Ex-City man Paul Power providing that terrific cross for Graham Sharp to head the first after just 6 minutes. Brian Robson equalised with a speculative shot, but the Blues kept up the pressure with what was their best performance of the season so far. Stoppage time in the first half, Sheedy to take the corner, headed away by Robson, Stephen Rowe. Here's Sheedy again. Picked on by Watson. Well blocked by Severbeck. Whiteside in trouble though. Chance for Heath. And Severbeck did really well to get back there. Either the Dane or, I don't know, maybe more likely his goalkeeper Chris Turner, just denying Adrian Heath. But it's all Everton at the moment. Watson and Mountfield are still forward. Stephen will take the corner. Flicked on by Graham Sharp, away by Stapleton. Sheedy! 2-1 to Everton, and no more than they've deserved. Sheedy with a right foot for once, restoring the Everton lead. It was never going to reach Remy Moses, headed away by Adrian Heath deep in defence, helped on by Graham Sharp. He'll have to chase it himself, but he's got more in two minds. And suddenly here's Kevin Langley free on the right, Heath and Wilkinson in support. Adrian Heath, oh, superb goal. It's Adrian Heath's first since the Charity Shield, and it's been well worth the wait. He started all that way back on the edge of his own penalty area, and he was there again, 75 yards later, to beat Severbeck to Langley's delicious cross and score with an equally delicious header. No First Division side retained its unbeaten record for longer, despite all the injuries. The shadow squad even played in a cup final, although the Screen Sports Super Cup gave us little to cheer.
The referee has blown for a penalty for handball. As the cross came in, a second penalty for Everton. Well, Trevor Stephen has missed one. Who are they going to get to take this one?
Matt, I don't understand that.
Graham Sharp.
I don't understand why that was a penalty. There's no way that the player played that.
Graham Sharp to give Everton some consolation. 2 minutes left. Generous decision, an emphatic penalty.
Three successive league defeats against Spurs, Arsenal and Charlton served to check the Blues' early momentum in the title race. By mid-October, they were in need of a shot in the arm. The return of Neville Southall against Watford provided it, although the day belonged to Derek Mountfield, back in favour because Dave Watson was injured. 9 minutes into the second half, a corner to Everton on the right-hand side. Look out for Mountfield, ready to pounce on Steve Terry's mistake to give Everton the lead. But in the very next minute, Mountfield was to concede a penalty from which Kenny Jackett equalised. An hour gone, 1-1. Here's Langley. Forward to Power. Barnes forcing him inside. Heath. Power again. Ooh, now did Richardson catch him? Or Bardsley maybe? Well, one of them did. It's a penalty. Now, Trevor Stephen converted an important penalty in the 2-0 win at Southampton last Saturday. Facing an old Everton friend in Steve Sherwood. Now, which way will he go? The wrong way. Sweetly struck. Everton in front for the second time in the game. Eight minutes left then. 2-2 the score. Ratcliffe in towards the head of Sharp. Away by Sims. Only as far as Alan Harper. Looking for Wilkinson or Mountfield maybe. Well, would you believe it? He scored again. I suppose you could call it a sort of hat-trick. Two for Everton, and an own goal for Watford in between. Well, he's got a penalty to answer for too, but a winner's smile on the face of Derek Mountfield. Everton were back in third place. Kevin Sheedy was back after injury. October the 28th, and a third round tie in the new Littlewoods Challenge Cup against Sheffield Wednesday, waiting for a win over the Blues for more than 20 years. Sheedy's in-swinging corner here, after 2 minutes, kept them waiting. Paul Wilkinson is the man on the near post who scored, or at least claimed the goal. But there were no doubts over the scorer of Everton's second goal. Sheedy just managing to free Parr. Stephen, the target for the cross. Away, though, by Madden. Heath. Oh, wow. Well, you won't see a better volley than that. A gem from Adrian Heath. The best part of 25 yards out, a blinding volley. And Graham Sharp's look says it all. 11 minutes gone, it's 2-0. Sheedy's corner, short to Harper. Chapman's header falling for Mountfield. Well, it's the big fellow's third of the week. 3-0. It's his fourth if you count his own goals. But it sealed Everton's place in the fourth round of the Littlewoods Cup. Sharp. Neatly down to Sheedy. Wilkinson arriving. Oh, great goal. Paul Wilkinson makes it four. That's seven goals in three games in this competition for him. A spectacular finish, but the return of Kevin Sheedy's educated left foot, the telling factor. Defeat at West Ham was followed by an ill-tempered Goodison draw with Chelsea. McAllister's handball here not only led to a penalty, it set him on the slide towards an early bath. It was that sort of game. The Blues were in fact twice in front, but Colin Pates denied them victory 2 minutes from time. Good wins at Leicester, then Norwich in the Cup, were followed by a wind-blown Derby stalemate in front of 48,000 at Goodison. Then, at the end of November, a trip to Main Road and a trip down memory lane for Paul Power.
And Suckling's hesitated, Adam setting up the chance, and the goal is from Adrian Heath. Perry Suckling, who had what he described as the worst game of his short league career last Saturday at Arsenal, found himself in no man's land then. He started to come and then realised he'd made a mistake, an error of judgment, a good early cross from Adams and swept in by Heath. A match that's been full of incident and more to come. With Power, he comes back with a goal that he could hardly turn and celebrate while they were celebrating on the bench. Paul Power. He's been involved with Manchester City in one capacity or another for some 15 years, but now he's Everton through and through. And through his left foot, they lead 2-1 at Main Road. And Suckling fell late, and it brushed his hands on the way in. We've had so many opportunities to strike at goal today, Kevin Sheedy. He is Everton's top scorer, and Sharp played onside by McCarthy. Unselfishly delivered for Heath, and that wraps it up. And that really is the essence of Everton. They force you into mistakes, and they have the quality to make the most of chances when they do come their way. All credit to Graham Sharp. He gave the opportunity to Heath, the goal to Heath.
The Four Members' Cup was next on the agenda, although only for 7,500 hardy souls. Their lords are rewarded with five top-class goals against Newcastle. The first, a typical Sheedy strike, although hit on the half volley for once. With just 6 minutes gone, Everton made it 2-0. Sharp, looking left, then right, and eventually finding Adams. That's a good cross. Sharp, that'll do. Fine goal. Set up in the first place by Graham Sharp, and finished in the right place by Graham Sharp. Sheedy to Parr. Sheedy, Stephen, Power, Sheedy, that was a bit special, wasn't it? Sharp. Oh. Well, it deserved a goal, didn't it? Pinball Wizards. They were opening doors all over the place there. And Graham Sharp just stuck out his chest to run off a terrific combination. Adams. Stephen. Ratcliffe. That's a searching ball. He's the man lurking. Thomas the man lunging. Penalty. So Trevor Stephen with the opportunity. No, I think they're going to call forward Graham Sharp, who's on a hat-trick. Yes, I think so. Summoned by the Gladys Street. Command performance from the spot. And I do believe that's his first ever hat-trick for Everton. Great moment for Sharpie. A hat-trick completed in just 38 minutes. Remaining. 4-1, the Everton lead. Harper's flick. Stephen. He's turning. Sheedy supporting. He's scoring. They really have scored some delightful goals. Harper, number two, there played a walk-on part, or a flick-on part, I suppose. But Sheedy and Heath had the starring roles. Everton were now playing their best football of the whole season. Defeat on the Luton plastic apart, they won 10 in a row. Next up, Norwich on December the 6th, hit first by that well-taken Paul Power goal. With Gary Stevens and Neil Poynton now fit again, Power was making his mark in midfield, even scoring goals with his right foot. After half an hour, it was 2-0. Putney trying something he couldn't really deliver there. Heath alert to the danger, gun out. Now what's he doing? Sheedy, handball was it? Yes, Steve Bruce, penalty to Everton. Goodness only knows what gun the goalkeeper has to complain about. It was his party trick outside the box which let Sheedy in. John Lovett, the referee, has heard enough. The book's out, and then if he hears any more from gun, Norwich may well be looking for another goalkeeper to face this kick. The delay not doing anything for Trevor Stevens' nerves. Gunn has been booked and Gunn has been beaten. Stevens' sixth penalty of the season. 2-0. Just 12 minutes remaining now. Stevens with the high ball for Sharp, away though by Bruce. Poynton surging forward, Sheedy, Poynton, oh what a lovely bonus. Neil Poynton's first goal for Everton. And 6 miserable months on the sidelines must seem a little more worthwhile now. Back from injury, enjoying his moment of glory. A little over a year ago he was playing for Scunthorpe. The next goal requires no commentary at all. Goal of the season? Well, it certainly took some beating, did number four. That's it, hit the rewind button and take another look. Magical goal scorer Adrian Heath turned magical goal provider 25 minutes into the next home game against Wimbledon. Watch how Trevor Stephen demands that Inchi choose the best of the two or three alternatives that are open to him here. Classic stuff. On the day that Peter Reid returned to the first team picture, albeit briefly, as a substitute. The last shopping Saturday before Christmas, full of good tidings. Harper. It's Thorne's header. Then Powers. And Thorne's clearance. Just over half an hour gone. Ratcliffe keeping the heat on. That's a great ball for Stephen. Sharp. Stevens. Heath. Stephen. Goalkeeper never saw it. All that. Kevin Sheedy makes it 2-0. And Wimbledon in danger of being overrun by what's becoming another irresistible Everton performance. Stevens. Harper. Stephen. Making space for Gary Stevens again. Oh, that's a great cross. Well, I suppose it'd have to be pretty accurate for Adrian Heath to head a goal. The Wimbledon defence not exactly short of height. But this little fella's not short of spring either. He's really finding his scoring touch. And no wonder with that kind of service. Boxing Day, St James's Park, Newcastle. Arguably Everton's best display of the whole season. But maybe not quite the best commentator.
Swung away by Kevin Sheedy and sharp breaks for Everton.
That's Heath, actually.
Heath, rather, on that far side. Faced by Kenny Wharton. Good ball to Harper. Harper inside, and this should be Everton's first goal. It is. It's there.
I think Paul Power's the name that you're looking for.
Sharp. Power. Paul Power gets the ball inside, and a chance for Heath.
I think you'll find that Stephen.
Adrian Heath
is going to score in a minute. That's Stephen.
Newcastle United nil, Everton 2. Everton in though quickly on these Newcastle midfielders. Sharp.
No, he's the tall one. That's Heath.
Finds Power. Power inside for Heath for Stevens.
Stephen.
Oh, he wrong footed Martin Thomas. I think that was a missed kick by Trevor Stevens.
Now, come on, don't start getting like that.
Went to an Everton player. Now Everton coming forward again. Trevor Stephen on that far side, going down the Everton right. Heath gets the ball into the net for four for Everton. Heath.
That's it, word perfect. Everton were approaching perfection themselves now. 2 days later, Leicester were blown away at Goodison. Paul Wilkinson emphasising their squad strength yet again in the absence of the suspended Graham Sharp. Wilkinson's very presence forcing O'Neill to concede the corner. And these opening 15 minutes have been busy ones for the Leicester defence. Sheedy will take the corner. Just see Watson forward on the left of the picture. This from Andrews. Stephen, though, looped in towards Watson. Heath, they're at it again. 1-0. The Everton goal machine slips into gear once more. Heath's 13th of the season. Watson's formidable presence setting it up. Morgan asking for trouble there. He'll get it too. Here's Sheedy. Wilkinson, coolly done. It was handed to him on a plate in truth. But he still had to gobble it up. Paul Wilkinson making it 2-0 with less than a quarter of the game gone. Battling away gamely there, the odds stacked against him. Away by Morgan, that's another poor one. There's a chance perhaps for Paul Wilkinson, yes! An own goal, I think, by John O'Neill. I'm not sure there's much more can happen to this Leicester defence. Paul Wilkinson seems to be saying, that's my goal. If it is, that's 10 for the season for him. Sheedy. Stevens. To Stephen, to Heath. Oh, delightful stuff. Another header for Inchy. That's 8 goals in 7 games now for Adrian Heath. But the sheer balance and grace of Trevor Stephen, the lovely thing about that goal, how did he manage to squeeze it back? Poynton bringing it clear. Keith. Aspinall running wide to his left. Sheedy down the middle. Oh! Well, I think he's taking the mickey now. What a left foot that is. Blast it, curl it, chip it. He could have done any one of half a dozen things there. But I rather like that chip, I must say. 5-0. 3 minutes to go. Everton stay second. New Year's Day now. The festive feast continues against Aston Villa. A goalless first half followed quickly by the somewhat fortunate Alan Harper breakthrough. Still not quite sure how that found its way in. But it triggered another stylish and emphatic Everton victory. Lovely touch by Heath. My word, there's some miles left in these legs of Paul Powers yet. Elliot in trouble. Stephen in for the kill. There's opportunism for you. Quick thinking, quick reactions. Trevor Stephen makes it two. And a handshake for the evergreen Paul Power. Wilkinson, Stephen. Now Heath. Sheedy. Oh, pick that one out. I can't believe there's anybody in the country in better form at the moment. Kevin Sheedy's spoiling us with goal after goal of rare quality. 3-0, and Sheedy a joy to watch these last couple of months. Sadly, he was to play only seven more full games all season. Graham Sharp's virtuoso effort, Everton's first on the QPR plastic, made it 15 points out of 15 over the holiday period and cemented the Blues in second spot behind Arsenal. Their bid to reach a fourth successive FA Cup final started against Southampton on January the 10th. Sharp cashing in on indecision between Mark Ryde and particularly Peter Shilton to give the Blues a 36-minute lead. It was a tight and bruising cup tie though. Gordon Hobson eventually poached an equaliser just after the hour mark. Colin Clark had his moments for Southampton too, but one moment of deadly precision involving Sheedy and Sharp ultimately settled it. Look at the quality of Sheedy's cross here, hit with the minimum of delay. Here it comes. And what about that for a centre-forward's header? Amazing to think that Sharp, like Sheedy, spent most of the remainder of the season on the sidelines. But reinforcements were on the way. Ian Snowden, snatched from under Liverpool's nose, made his debut in the next league game against his brother Glyn and his side, Sheffield Wednesday. Well, that's a terrific cross by Sheedy. Oh, Chapman seemed to punch that away. There was a big shout. Linesman's flags up, raised across his chest, and that means penalty. And the one man who's not complaining is the man who handled it, Lee Chapman. So Trevor Stephen against his former teammate Martin Hodge. Ooh, well, Hodge got a hand to it. But I think if you review that, you'll see quite clearly that Chapman did too. And that's why Stephen has put the Blues in front. Mark Smith, the man in bother with the referee, Michael Peck. Free kick is the verdict. Half an hour gone, still 1-0. Sheedy will take it. Deflected. Watson. Oh, well taken. Dave Watson's first goal for Everton. Enjoyed by his teammates as much as by the man himself. I think Gary Megson touched the free kick. Watson Well, a bit more decisive with his head than he was with his boots, capping his steady improvement and earning a really warm Goodison reception. Ironically, Watson was injured minutes later and missed the Littlewoods Cup defeat by Liverpool. But Peter Reid and Pat Van den Hau were now back in harness. Bradford City had been knocked out of the FA Cup. And on February the 7th, Everton hit the top by coming from behind to beat Coventry. Gary Stevens claimed that goal at first, but the deflection belonged to Nick Pickering. It marked the end of a Coventry-dominated first half and was a vital turning point in many ways. With the second period just 7 minutes old, Reid and Stephen combined down the right. Watch as Paul Power's header cannons off Lloyd McGrath's hand. Watch too to see if you, like Coventry, think that McGrath may have been pushed before jumping. Well, you need a little bit of luck along the way. John Key said penalty. Trevor Peake said all sorts. But he didn't change the referee's mind. Oh, go on, it's hard enough beating these. We never win here. Well, think of all the friends you'd make in Anfield. We'll give you a cup final ticket. Even Trevor Stevens' penalty needed a little bit of help from the frame to find a way in. But all that mattered was that the Blues were in front and on top. In the 66th minute of the game, they showed just why they were on top. That's Watson forward. Stephen, just denied by Peake, or is it McGrath? Here's Watson again, that was away by Kilcline. Harper though, Heath, oh great header. Terrific goal, and that's the Everton that's climbed into title contention. As they climb to the very top of the league at just about the same time as they did last year, you wonder if they can stay there this time. February the 22nd, the dogfight over Plough Lane. Could it be that we actually started that cup tie too well?
Little touch for Heath. Good position for Adrian Heath. The goalkeeper's had it. Wilkinson's in the middle. It's a goal for Everton. Wilkinson the scorer. And Everton caught them out, ironically, with a long ball. It found Heath. He went round Dave Besant, and from then on it was a matter of whether the defenders on the line could stop Wilkinson. And the answer, quite emphatically, as he went up with Sanchez, was no. Fourth minute of the match. Heath goes round the goalkeeper here. And as the ball comes in, Wilkinson gets up and Everton are in front.
One of five consecutive matches without a win. Out of the FA Cup at Wimbledon, soon out of the full Members' Cup too. Less than 8,000 saw this Paul Wilkinson goal against Charlton in a match decided by a penalty shootout in the end, on a freezing night when Everton twice held the lead. The faithful few were treated to extra time. Although it was so cold, I'm not sure they really wanted it. Van den Hau forward. Chance. And another. Stephen. Well, the second time of asking, Trevor Stephen able to take the chance. Everton back in front. But now it was the Championship or nothing. Wayne Clark was signed from Birmingham City and made his debut in front of the live television cameras at Watford, where Everton again made the best possible start.
Which he accepted. Heath, cross to Van den Hau. And Everton beginning to move with purpose now. Heath is outside, but Power is outside him too. And Heath comes in and a goal for Everton by Adrian Heath. And he'll be thrilled about that because he's been going through a really thin spell.
but Everton have taken the lead, and Vandenhout to Power, whose earlier interception really set this move up. It was the driven cross, and Heath came in to head it in at the near post. Only his second goal in the last 13 games, but it does confirm his position as Everton's top scorer. It's his 16th of the season.
Goals from Blissett and Falco in the last quarter cost Everton the title lead, and yet they were to drop only four more points. Two hard-earned home wins over Southampton and Charlton got them moving again, although it needed an own goal from Mark Wright to get the ball rolling. Twelve minutes gone, Everton 1, Southampton 0. Ratcliffe again. Watson. Wright's header, only for Heath though. Here's Power. Oh, how did he get that one in? Peter Shilton angry with his fullback Forrest for allowing Power the chance. But the England goalkeeper must take some of the blame for the smile on Paul Power's face. 2-0 to Everton. Stephen again. Gary Stevens. Watson, that'll tie it up. 54 minutes gone. Dave Watson throws himself forward to make it 3-0. Wasn't even a challenge from the Southampton player. Shilton slipped on the line. But Watson takes some stopping. He's a mean and powerful man, and he's got the Blues back in winning ways. We've had 43 minutes. Still Everton 0, Charlton 0. Precious little sign of a goal, you have to say that. Watson hooking it forward. Stephen controlled that one well. Helped on towards Paul Parr. Good save by Boulder. He surely now, is he clipped by Paul Miller? Yes, penalty. Adrian Heath in considerable pain, actually. He was really savaged by Paul Miller. A goal, a racing certainty at the time. And the appearance of Mr. Wright's notebook, a racing certainty too. Miller will be cautioned. Now, Heath appears to be okay. And Stephen, after waiting very patiently, will take on Bob Boulder from 12 yards. That is Street End. Half-time almost upon us. And Everton will have an interval lead. Thanks to the coolness from the spot of Trevor Stephen. Seven minutes left to play. 1-1 the score. A point really isn't good enough for Everton. Here's Clark with a chance to do something about it. Oh, Stevens! Gary Stevens! A tackle, I think, as much as anything. But what a well-timed tackle. The ball flying in as Mark Reid tried to clear. And Everton may just have sneaked the win that they need to close the gap on Liverpool to 6 points. A week later, that gap was halved. Liverpool were ambushed by Wimbledon as Wayne Clark gunned down Arsenal from long range.
Oh, he's giving it away. And Clark is there. And he scores! What a silly goal to give away. And what an opportunist first goal for Everton for Wayne Clark. Red faces in the Arsenal defence, not least from goalkeeper John Lukic. And a smile on the face of the Everton number nine. He comes away out of his goal, half hits it, and you'll notice he gives it up now. You can see that that's a perfect chip there by Wayne Clark.
And 7 days later, the Blues returned to the capital to beat Chelsea with a great Alan Harper winner, which won back top spot. Everton were never headed again. Their first half football against West Ham was champion stuff. Reid. Flicked on by Watson. Clark, Wayne Clark's first Goodison goal. 20 minutes of ceaseless pressure, rewarded by the inevitable breakthrough. Great moment for Clark, a really crisp shot. Everton one up. West Ham being harassed into error after error. Here's Reid with a bit of daylight. Oh! That is Peter Reid, isn't it? A left-footed volley that Kevin Sheedy would have been proud of. It's Reid's first goal for well over a year. And they're worth waiting for when they're that good, aren't they? Yeah, it's me, Reedy. Stephen just unable to control the header. He knows how to win it back, though. Everton altogether sharper and quicker. Stephen setting up Gary Stevens. Say, that flew in faster than Reed's. What a goal! A guided missile from Gary Stevens. 33 minutes, 3-0, and it could really have been 6 or 7 already. Only 6 more minutes of this first half for West Ham to endure. Stevens flick, Watson's finish, 4-0. They just can't stop scoring. Watson, the latest addition to the list. He put two West Ham defenders in the net with the ball, but that's how Big Dave does things. And Everton can't have put a better 45 minutes together for years. Liverpool's defeat at Norwich capped a momentous day. Half of Goodison Park travelled down to Villa Park the following Saturday to witness a brief but spectacular reappearance from Kevin Sheedy. Dave Watson again played a vital part in the 53rd minute goal, moving forward to clear the stage for the Master Blaster. And I see one or two of you found your way down there. Incredible support. But there's always got to be one, hasn't there? 2 days later, Easter Monday, Newcastle United were paid off by a Wayne Clark treble back at Goodison Park. Heath, way as far as Poynton, power, Clark, 48 minutes, the breakthrough has arrived. Great cross from Peter Pan, as they call him now. What a signing for power has proved to be. And Wayne Clark, sniffing like his brother used to do, makes it 1-0. Harper on the break. Here's Heath now, stealing a yard. Oh, good turn. Clark, surely. Yes. Knew just how much time he had. That's an expert goal scorer at work. And he's given Everton breathing space with 9 minutes to go. Wayne Clark, skillfully set up by Adrian Heath, makes it 2-0. And Everton happy now to see out these last few seconds in the knowledge that Liverpool are a goal down to Manchester United at Old Trafford. Snowden's cross. Stevens appear to be impeded there. Here's Power popping up on the right. Clark, hat-trick. His first ever. In just his 8th game for Everton, who are now the champions-elect. The party has started at Goodison. They're very, very close now. And Wayne Clark has put them within touching distance of the title. It would have been a special feeling to have clinched that title at Anfield, of course. Everton played well enough to have won there, but they didn't. Nevertheless, Kevin Sheedy's mightiest strike yet was itself worth the admission price.
Now, Mike Hooper knows all about Kevin Sheedy because back in September, in a match in the Super Cup, the final of that competition was played between Liverpool and Everton over two legs. at the Kop end. Hooper was guilty of a misjudgment and Sheedy saw the gap and belted the ball past Mike Hooper for an Everton goal. What will happen this time? Sheedy takes and scores! Hooper couldn't come up with the answer again. Kevin Sheedy. Hooper is left to reflect. There's delight from those wearing blue. After 16 minutes, it's 1-1. One from the extensive catalogue of great Sheedy strikes.
So 8,000 Evertonians and ITN and all the rest set out for Norwich on May the 4th.
But after Saturday's scoreless draw, the tension was high. Norwich, though, diffused it by handing Everton the lead within a minute. It was Vandenhau's first of the season. It'll go down as the one which won the title. For as the match wore on, Norwich came on strongly, and a nervous Everton simply protected their slender lead. Howard Kendall's half-time team talk was no doubt about defending in numbers. It worked most of the time. The occasional panic, though, did nothing to calm the fans down. The manager, meanwhile, was on the edge of his seat. At the end, the man who saw Liverpool snatch both the league and cup from him last season looked more than relieved as his team ran for cover.
I'm absolutely delighted, really. I mean, it's been tremendously satisfying to win the championship again after narrowly missing out last season.
And even better for taking from Liverpool.
You don't mind who you take championships off. As I say, I mean, our fans were desperately disappointed we missed out on the league championship and the FA Cup last season to Liverpool. And we've reversed it this season.
The new champions were chaired home to Goodison for the crowning 5 days later, after first disposing of Luton Town's plans to spoil the party. Stevens, fun read. 1-2 is with Watson. He could go all the way here. Great save, hit the crossbar. Sharp or Heath maybe now. Who made the save there? The fullback, I think. Rob Johnson, yes, penalty. There are those in white who disagree. But Johnson, number two, scooped the ball in then. Have a look at it again as Heath and Sharp closed in. And they can complain all they want. But the referee is... Ooh, a save. Well, he's not going to win a prize in a coconut shy, is he? And just as well for him, or he could have been on his way. Les Sealy then, with his side leading by a goal to nil, to face Trevor Stephen. Goalkeeper went left, ball went right, Everton on terms. Watson with a long ball forward. North header up rather than out. Johnson under pressure from Heath. Here's Stephen. Caught by North, was he? Yes, another penalty. 2 in 3 minutes. Little argument this time. Trevor Stephen just bundled over by Stacey North. Now Stephen sent the last one to Seeley's right. He guessed wrong then. Just re-spotting the cue ball. The other way, and the goalkeeper guessed wrong again. Stephen 2 up in his personal battle of wits with Sealy. Everton 2-1 up as a result. Half an hour to go to party time in the presentation of the trophies. Here's Stevens, Sharp with a touch, Sharp with a goal. There's no feeling like it. Scoring down at the Gladley Street end with 44,000 in the place. Everton have come from behind to lead 3-1 on their big day. And that's why they're the champions. And so to the moment that 22 First Division teams dream about each August, maybe no more than half a dozen seriously contemplate, and which only Everton and you, their fans, could enjoy in 1987. Two trophies, the Today Sponsors Memento, presented by Bobby Robson, and the century-old Football League original, handed over by the Everton chairman, Philip Carter. Sit back and enjoy the moment again, because no other supporters in the country can. Moments to show the grandchildren. A title won with 86 points, 9 more than Liverpool in second place, and one with 2 games to spare. A 9th title in all, won by a team average age for this Luton game, just 25 and a half, only Peter Reid over the age of 26. A title won without actually finding a scoring sensation to replace Gary Lineker, but with goals shared around, Stephen 14, Sheedy 13, Heath 11 and so on. A title won by the efforts of 23 different players because of the ravaging injuries which cost the senior men more than 200 games on the sidelines in all. And a title left to Evertonians to remember Howard Kendallby, a man who stood on the sidelines in the background there and pointed the way.
turn.